Arise, O Lord, save me, my God, thou hast smitten all the power of my enemies. The teeth of Because I noticed across the face of my folly, I have been wretched and bowed down. Until the end, all the day long, I will be downcast face. For my Lord can hold the body and has been given my flesh. I have lifted and humbly seen me, and the Lord has been of my heart. The Lord before thee shall make desire my Lord has not been to me. My heart is troubled, my strength is filled, and the light of my eyes even this is not with me. My friends, my neighbors drew nigher against me, and stood at my neighbors of kin stood afar off. The day that set after my soul to God, which they have thought evil to me, spent many days. And craft myself day long and meditate. But as I was of the devil, and I heard the knock, and was a religious man opened not his mouth. And I became as a man that heard not, and that happened was not my reproof. For thee, I hope the Lord thou art unto me, O Lord my God. For so that if ever my enemies rejoice over me, gave me my people shaken. Those men spake both the words against me. For I am good as a church, and my sorrow is continued before me. God, if there are my enemies, I will take heed concerning my sin. But my enemies stood on my strong good and not, and they can't trust their own fight. They that rend me, evil for their son, makes them a pursuit of goodness. Forsaken now, the Lord my God, depart not from me, be attentive unto my help. O Lord, my salvation. Forsaken not, O Lord my God, depart not from me, be attentive unto my help. O Lord, my salvation. O God, my God, the King of our joy is gone, my soul is thirsty for thee, who often hath my flesh longed after thee, and let bear thy pride and watch over me. So in the same shall I pray before thee through thy power and glory, for thy mercy is better than life, and it shall praise thee. So shed blessed in thy life, my thy name will lift up my hands. As we bear on that, so my soul will go. I will lift the grace and shall my mouth praise thee, and remember thee on my bed, and on my head, and on thee. Thou art on my help, and shall go me, who I rejoice. And so I plead unto thee, thy right hand has been equipped to help me. And as for these, the man of this heart, my soul, they shall go down to heaven with hearts of the earth. They shall be slender, the gems of the sword, close to the cross, shall we be. For the king shall be glad in God, and want to praise his word, by him, not with them. At the dawn of the day, the bounty of God is upon my helper. And shall the bed weep, will I rejoice. My soul hath pleaded unto thee. Thy right hand hath been equipped to call me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Now and ever, and through ages of ages. Amen. The Lord God of my salvation, my day I cry, my night before thee, let my prayer come before thee. Bow down thy ear to my supplication, and the load of the evil of my soul, and my life in the Hades hath gone not. I am counted with them that go down into the dead, I become as men, without help. Among the dead, my body is slain and asleep in the grave, whom thou rememberest no more, they are cut off from my hand. They laid me in the lowest pit of darkness and shadow of death. Against me is thy anger made strong, and all thy billows hast thou brought upon me. As thou hast removed my friends apart from me, they have made me abomination unto themselves. I have been delivered out, and have not come forth, my eyes are grieved for profit. I have cried to thee, O Lord, O holy wrong, and I have stretched out my hands. Even the dead will now with wonders, with the sharp position, raise them up to the end of thy sleep. They shall in the grave tell thy mercy and thy truth and thy destruction. They shall thy wonders be known in the darkness, and in thy righteousness in the land that is forgotten. But as for me and thee, O Lord, I cry, and the morning shall I heard from the Lord. Wherefore, Lord, dost thou cast out my soul, and turn from this way. A poor man am I, and troubles from my youth, yea, have been exalted, I saw the rock of distress. My fury is cast upon me, and my fears have sorely troubled me. They came around about me like water. All the day long they come to see about together. Now as you move apart from me, from a neighbor and my acquaintance, because of my misery. O Lord God, my salvation, my day I have cried, my night before thee. Let my prayer come before thee, bow down thy ear to my supplication. Bless the Lord, O my soul, all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, forget not all that he hath done for thee. Gracious unto all thy iniquities, who give up all thy infirmities, who redeemeth thy life from corruption, and grant thee with mercy and compassion. Fill up thy desire with good things, thy youth shall be renewed in sinfulness. The Lord performed deeds of mercy and executed judgment for all that are wrong. He had made his way to know unto Moses and the sons of Israel and him that he would. Compassion and merciful is the Lord, long suffering and plenteous mercy. to our sins and to reward us. For according to the height of heaven, the Lord hath made this person prevail over the earth. As far as the east is from the west, so far hath the root of our iniquities from us. Like as the Father hath compassion upon his Son, so hath the Lord have compassion upon him. We know it where we are made, and yet remember that we are dust. As for man, his days are the grass, the flower, and even so shall it blossom forth. For when the wind is passed over and finished, hope of God, and the water will want its place to run. But the mercy of the Lord is from eternity, even unto eternity, upon them that fear him. And his righteousness is upon sons, upon them that keep his testament, and the mercy of man. The Lord in heaven hath prepared his throne, and his kingdom to look over all. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, by his strength, and perform his word, and hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all you his hosts, his ministers that do his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works, and every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul, in every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. O Lord, hear my prayer, give ear to my supplication, and my truth. Hearken unto me in my righteousness, and enter not into judgment with my servant, for my sight shall no man living be justified. For the enemy hath persecuted my soul, he hath humbled my life down to the earth. He hath sat in the darkness of those that are among the dead, and my spirit within me has become slumber. Within me my heart is troubled. I remember the days of old, I meditated on all thy works. I pondered the creation of thy hands. I stretched forth my hands unto thee, my soul thirsted after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit thou hast away. Turn not thy face away from me, lest I be like them that look down into the dead. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for in thee have I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for in thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, and in thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of righteousness, for thy name's sake, O Lord, shalt thou bring me. In thy righteousness shalt thou bring my soul out of perdition. In thy mercy shalt thou utterly destroy my enemies, and thou shalt cut off all them that have put my soul for my consumer. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and do not to the judgment of thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and do not to the judgment of thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me to land of righteousness. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto ages and ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 and glory to you. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, dear God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, dear God. O our God, our hope, glory to thee.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. The peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those who in faith, reverence, and the fear of God into therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, Schuyler, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those that are persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. All we need to remember and words are all holy, immaculate. Blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages.
thanks, glory to thee.
Verily, life was placed in the grave, and the seals were applied to the stone. And the soldiers guarded Christ as though it was sinking in. But the Lord rose, smiting his enemies in an invisible way.
Verily, joy did come before it, and made a sign of that tomb. Simeon did interpret by divine resurrection of death and hope. Thou didst ascend into the grave as one who is dead. For thou who didst convey the gates of Hades and is rise free of corruption and salvation of the Lord, being the master of Christ our God, and his life of those who are here.
Now the run of two ages, so they should tell them, pray or worship the Theotokos, that Son, Christ our God, who was willingly nailed upon the cross, did rise from the dead that he might save our souls.
Save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord,
mercy upon us who are despised, and make us good and chosen vessels.
For into the Father, and into the Son, and into the Holy Spirit, for now and ever and in the ages of ages. Amen. Verily, in the Holy Spirit is the cause of salvation for all, for when he dwelleth upon us worthily, he doth raise him speedily with earthly things, doth wing him and cause him to grow, and doth rank him in the heavenly places. Were not the Lord in our midst, we would not be possible for any of us to stand firm in his wrestling with the enemy. For only thereby do the victors obtain the exaltation of victory.
Woe to me, how shall I escape the enemies while I am a lover of sin? Wherefore deliver not my soul, O word, like a bird to their teeth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and now and ever and in the ages of ages. Amen. Verily through the Holy Spirit is everyone made divine, and him is pleasure, understanding, safety, and blessing. For he is equal to the Father and the Word together. They who trust in the Lord are feared by their enemies and are wondered at by all, for their sight is very high.
The party of the righteous hath secured thee as a succor, O Savior, and therefore shall not reach out its hands to the priest.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and in the ages of ages. Amen. Verily the Holy Spirit hath mind of all, for him do all the heavenly hosts worship, and every breath to love.
Thou art God, and we know none other beside thee. We we call upon thy name. O come, all ye faithful, let us adore Christ's holy resurrection. For lo, to the cross is joy coming to all the world. Ever blessing the Lord, let us sing his resurrection. For in that he endured the cross for us, he has destroyed death by death.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to thy great mercy, and according to the multitude of thy compassion, blot out my transgression. Wash me purely from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my iniquity, my sin is ever before me. Against thee only have I sinned and done this evil before thee, that thou mightest be justified in thy words, and prevail when thou art judged. For behold, I was conceived in iniquities, and sins to my mother bear me. For behold, thou hast loved truth, and hidden secret things of thy wisdom, when thou made manifest unto me. Thou shalt sprinkle me with this, and I shall be made clean. Thou shalt wash me, and I shall be made whiter than snow. Thou shalt make me hear joy and gladness, as long as the humble they shall rejoice. Turn thy face away from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Save me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not thy Holy Spirit from me. Restore to me the joy of thy salvation, that thy burning spirit establish me. I shall teach transgressors thy ways, and thou that shall turn back unto thee. Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, thou God of my salvation. My tongue shall rejoice in thy righteousness. O Lord, thou shalt open my lips, and my mouth shall declare thy praise. For thou hadest desired sacrifice, thy covenant. With whole burnt offering thou shalt not be pleased. A sacrifice unto God is a broken spirit. A heart that is broken and humble, God will not despise. Do good, O Lord, in thy pleasure unto thine, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built up. Then shall I be pleased with sacrifice of righteousness. With oblation and whole burnt offering, then shall they offer bullocks upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, through the intercessions of the apostles, O thou who art merciful, Lord of the multitude of our transgressions, both now and then, and through ages and ages, amen.
Of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, the holy righteous ancestors of God, you are him and Anna of the great prince Vladimir of Kiev, equal to the apostles and to the martyrs, Kyrikos, and his mother Jovita of Tarsus, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all wise saints, you who seek the most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee in that mercy upon us.
Go be a fountain of
and the mother of the light, let us honor and magnify in song.
Thank you.
Yes, Lord, I believe with loving mind.
is made for he is set free, death is slain, and we are endowed with life. Wherefore in hymns of praise we cry aloud, blessed art thou, O Christ our God, who is us from these, Lord, be to thee.
Yeah.
the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the
Lord.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the
Lord.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Andrew, Thaddeus, Fowler, and Connor, let us pray to the
Lord.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those in the persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, whose blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. Wisdom, stand upright.
Thank you.
stop.
The reading from St. Paul's letter to Titus.
Let us attack.
Titus, my son, the saying is sure. I desire you to insist on these things, so that those who have believed in God may be careful to apply themselves to good deeds. These are excellent and profitable to men. But avoid stupid controversies, genealogies, dissensions, and quarrels over the law, for they are unprofitable and futile. As for a man who is factious, after admonishing him once or twice, knowing that such a man is perverted and sinful, he is self-condemned. When I send Artemis and Tychicus to you, do your best to come to me in Nicopolis, for I have decided to spend the winter there. Do your best to speed Zenas the lawyer and Apollos on their way. See that they lack nothing. And let our people learn to apply themselves to good deeds, so as to help the cases of urgent need and not to be unfruitful. All who are with me send greetings to you. Greet those who love us in the faith. Grace be with you all. Amen.
Peace be with you and greetings. Truly I say to you, till heaven and earth pass away, not an iota, not a dot will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Whoever then relaxes one of the least of these commandments and teaches men so shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But he who does them and teaches them shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Such distractions consume people's attention, inflame their passions, and make it so much harder to gain a pure and simple devotion to Christ and a sincere love for others. You can't love the person that you're flaming or
The flame wars on the internet are no way to advance the gospel of Christ, and certainly should be avoided by anyone seeking humility. So, yeah, I mean, that's just one example. But we are given a do and a don't in this little short epistle from Paul. Do give yourself to a productive life of good works which benefit others and your own soul as well. And don't be involved in quarrels or controversies that can distract you from Christ or cause division between otherwise good people. And I think this is a very timely word, considering the insanity that is all around us. Our entire nation seems to be engaged in a rancorous debate over just about anything imaginable. If you say one thing, somebody will take the other side. You can get in trouble for wearing the wrong color baseball cap, you know. We are witnessing the political and social balkanizing of our country, and I think this is not a very good thing for us, even if we're careful to avoid these kinds of things. Because the more we accept this as the new normal, this kind of debate, this kind of argument, this kind of stuff that goes on over politics and everything in our country, I think the easier it makes it for this kind of stuff to creep into the church, if this indeed is the new normal. You know, the less we might resist it, even as the world around us should fall apart at the seams, the church must continue to stand united, and all of its members committed to peace with one another and in the bond of love. And sometimes we forget that. I've seen some pretty nasty arguments on Facebook between members of the parish, and it's just sad. It's like, why? You know, why do we let our passions get so inflamed? Why do we get into these kinds of arguments? We should remember that we are brothers and sisters in Christ first. And it's not my job to correct you if you're wrong. You know? Well, it is my job. You know what I mean. In John 17, Jesus prayed that his followers might be one, even as he and the Father are one. That's huge. Think about it. To be united, to be one in purpose and will and intent, in work and action as the Father and the Son. This is what we're called to. And 20,000 distinct denominations within Christendom might indicate that we haven't done such a bang-up job of fulfilling this prayer. Of course, ignorance and a lack of humility are largely to blame for the division between Christians. People prefer to exalt their own opinions rather than surrender them to the divine will of being of one mind and one purpose in Christ. Paul instructed us, as we heard today, to deal firmly with the factious man in the church. That is to say, anyone whose conflicting personal beliefs bring discord and division among the faithful. He calls such people perverted, and rightly so. To cherish one's own thoughts and opinions above the holy community of Christ is the perversion of pride. Think how often we are urged in the scriptures to be at one and to be at peace with one another throughout the scriptures. To the Philippians, Paul wrote, "Make my joy complete by being of the same mind, maintaining the same love, united in spirit, intent on one purpose." In other words, imitate the Holy Trinity. To the Romans, he wrote, "Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud. Do not be conceited." And to the Corinthians, "Now I exhort you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, that you all agree, and that there be no divisions among you, but that you be made complete, and in the same mind, and in the same judgment." Well, these are just a few examples of the many pleas for unity that can be found throughout the New Testament. Something that's very foreign to our way of thinking today, where we cherish individual, you know, my right to believe what I want, and that this kind of silliness that's really just rooted in pride. Even here in the church, we know, struggled often to keep this kind of unity, which is why the apostles had to write these things so often. But it's also clear from history that they enjoyed a great deal of success in this as well. The people were once devoted to the apostles' teaching and fellowship, to the breaking of bread, in other words, the sacred unity of Holy Communion and prayer. They were united in giving of their own means and property to supply the needs of others. You know, you say 10% is not biblical. Okay, well, 100% is actually biblical. 10% is a neat compromise, I think. I wouldn't complain. They regarded one another truly as brothers and sisters, abolishing the divisions of race and wealth and social status. They thought of one another and of the good of the whole as being of higher importance than themselves. Wow. Imagine. You are more important than me. All of you are more important. Whenever and wherever this could be found, the church was truly the light of the world. This is where the light of God's love shone forth. A city set on a hill that cannot be hidden. Such unity where it existed was a true reflection of the love of God and the Holy Trinity and the oneness of the Godhead. But the tendency of men to hold their own opinions is strong and can lead them away from such a beautiful and godly unity. Brothers and sisters, we need to shake the dust of the world off our feet and not track its filth into our parish. May God forbid that there ever be division or factions within our holy community. We must work together to assure that everyone's true needs are met, from the youngest to the oldest, and that no one's care or no one's potential for ministry is neglected, because it's not all about serving you, it's about you serving. And this is how we love one another. And I need to add that many of us must step up our giving. You know, if you're waiting to give, sometimes when I talk with folks who aren't maybe giving, it's not that I seek people out, but they talk to me, their confession or whatever, I haven't been giving much. Why not? I usually have nosy, so I ask them, why aren't you giving? And the number one answer I'm given is, I forgot. How do you forget? Good news. We are setting up automatic payments. You can set it up with your employer at work, and it will deduct your time and send it every month so that you won't have to worry about it again. I'm serious, we're going to do that. I mean, if the problem is people forget, well, I want to address that. So we're going to do that. I don't want anyone to be neglected. But the other reason is that some people just feel like the church isn't really doing anything that they can get behind. You know, they want to support if there's more emphasis on youth ministry or young people, you know, 20s, 30-somethings, or, you know, when the parish does something that we can get behind, then we'll support. And, you know, that's completely wrong-headed. That's not, the kingdom of God is not a smorgasbord, you know, take what you want, you know. You become a Christian, you know how, by becoming a worshiper of God, by entering into the worshiping community. And how have people worshiped God since the beginning of time? Through sacrifice. You know, by giving, you become a worshiper of God, a member of the community. So if you think, well, I'll just wait and see what the church is going to do before I support it, yeah. I guess Jesus was wrong when he said, where your heart is, where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. You know, you give and your heart follows. And you begin to love the community. You begin to love God. You don't give and you don't progress in that. You really don't. So that's the reason why I harp on this all the time. It's important. It's not, you know, that I need more money. You know, my Range Rover is paid for, my Beverly Hills house is fine. You know, it's that my job is to help you be worshipers of God. And That's one of the ways you do it. You can't be a worshiper of God and not give. Just like you can't be a worshiper of God and engaged in habitual fornication or you know, something else. There's just some things that are not compatible. In a world, we might choose the causes that we support, and that's good. But in the church, it's chosen for us. We worship God through sacrifice and becoming one with one another. I say all these things not because there's any severe problem among us. We're, you know, except maybe we're keeping our budget tight. We could use a little help there. I don't sense any widespread divisions or difficulties or struggles in the parish. But I want us to know what's important. I want our parish to be that city on the hill that Jesus spoke of this morning, a lamp unto a darkened world. By the manifold blessings of God, we're already a bright spot in Orange County. And this is wonderful, but I think if we pay attention, we can shine even brighter. We are a place where there is love and a good degree of unity, you know, especially in light of the diversity in our marriage. And we can continue with that. We can love one another. We can support one another. We can learn to put each other higher, more important than myself. Yourself. Somebody's self. Leave behind every trace of selfishness and division and rancor and enmity and arguing and hate Trump or love Trump or, you know, this kind of stuff that's around us in the world, and just love one another in Christ to the glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Love it.
remembering his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Of our life in peace.
repentance for a Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ. Let us ask of the Lord. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. With one accord we may confess.
Inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, ever existing and eternally the same. Thou, thy only begotten Son, thy Holy Spirit. Thou it was who didst bring us from non existence into being, and when we have fallen away, didst raise us up again, and didst not cease to do all things until thou hast brought us back to heaven, and hast endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things, we give thanks unto thee, for thine only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit, for all things in which we know and of which we know not, and for all the benefits bestowed upon us, both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of archangels and then thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged many eyed sword along more than other pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, shouting, proclaiming, and saying,
Thank you.
churches in peace, safely honor them, and lay the bands, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who bear fruit in good works in thy holy churches and to remember the poor. And upon us all, send forth thy mercies. And grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise thine, O honorable and majestic name, of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Calling to remembrance all the saints again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
God be gracious unto us and have mercy upon us. O God, gracious unto me, a sinner, and have mercy. O God, be gracious unto me, a sinner, and have mercy.
Let us attend
holy things are for the holy.
Thank you.
administer this chalice, Holy Communion, to those who are chrismated members of the Orthodox Church. But please come up at the end of the service to receive your blessed bread, which you share with all.
With the fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins.
And just life everlasting.
Grace.
Lord, have mercy.
ourselves and each other, and build our life unto Christ our God.
We give thanks unto thee, O Lord, who lovest mankind, benefactor of our souls and bodies, for that thou hast vouchsafed us this day to feed to us with thy heavenly and mortal mysteries. Give, make straight our path, establish all of us in thy fear. Guard our life, make firm our steps through the prayers and intercessions of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary and of all thy saints. For thou art our sanctification, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them and recompense by thy divine power. And forsake us not who hope on thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to all civil authorities, to our armed forces, and to all the people. For every good and perfect gift is come above and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, especially the 630 of the Fourth Ecumenical Council, that we commemorate today, of St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God Joachim and Anna, of the great Prince Vladimir Basil of Kiev, equal to the apostles, the martyrs Carricos and his mother, Julieta of Tarsus, whose memory we celebrate today, have all the saints have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind. The prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. We sure read a lot of names every time we do a dismissal. Even 630 Holy Fathers of the Fourth Ecumenical Council. Well, thankfully, we didn't read all 30 of us. But we come from a large family, which we remember every Sunday. And living or dead doesn't matter, because there's no difference in Christ. If you're in Christ, you're alive. The term dead is the same as an oxymoron. And so today, as we do every third Sunday of the month, we will pray for our departed who have passed away during previous months of July, and bid rest to their souls.
Mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee. Hearken and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for repose of the souls of the servants of God, Elias, Maria, the priest, Peter, Thelma, Robert, Wayne, Sr., Andrew, Hope, Denise, Lisa, Alfonso, Vanagia, George, Albert, Virginia, Scott, Marty, Debbie, Dennis, Angelina, Helen, the Archimandrite, Yuan, the Archpriest, Nikolai, John, for the Priest, Gordon, Metropolitan Paul, for Richard, Eugene, for the Greeks killed during the Turkish invasion of Cyprus, for Dennis and for George, who are departed this life, and that God will pardon their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
That the Lord God will establish their souls with a just repose, the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and forgiveness of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and our God. Let us pray to the Lord.
O
God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and made powerless the devil and given life to thy world, you now the same Lord give rest to the souls of thy departed servants, Elias, Marina, Archpriest Peter, Thelma, Robert, Wayne, Sr., Andrew, Hope, Denise, Louisa, Alfonso, Helen, Ima, George, Albert, Virginia, Scott, Hardy, Debbie, Antonina, Ellen, Art, Mandrius, Milan, the Priest, Nikolai, for John, the Priest, Gordon, Metropolitan, Paul, Richard, Eugene, and the Greeks killed during the Turkish invasion of Cyprus, Dennis, and George, in a place of brightness, a place of virtue, a place of repose, whence all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. Pardon every sin which they have committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, and thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is true. Thou art the resurrection and the life and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory. Together with thy Father, who is everlasting, that all we good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
mercy on us and save us.